Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Thayer Hall at the Colburn School. In case of emergency, please take a moment to locate the exit nearest you. As a courtesy to performers and audience, please silence all cell phones and other electronic devices. Thank you and enjoy the program.
I'll be playing Nina Rota's Sarabanda and Toccata. Nina Rota was an Italian composer who's known for his film scores, and his works include music from the Godfather series, chamber works, orchestral pieces, and this harp solo piece. Sarabanda and Toccata is a two-movement piece. The first movement, Sarabanda, is a slow, beautiful, and melodic movement. And the Toccata, the last movement, is a lively and pleasant movement. I really enjoy playing this piece because it's so beautiful and it feels good on the hands. Thank you for coming and I hope you enjoy tonight's performance.
Thank you. and this is Min Hay, and tonight we will play the first and second movements of the Dvorak cello concerto. Dvorak wrote his cello concerto while he was in New York as the director of a conservatory. He wrote it in about 3 months, and during this time, his beloved sister-in-law, Josefina, was gravely ill. Dvorak incorporated a quote from one of his songs, which was Josefina's favorite, into the lullaby-like second movement. Learning this piece has really been an adventure for me. When I began, I really didn't like it very much. And now, after becoming friends with it and discovering its richness, I have come to love it. I am so excited to bring you along on this journey of internal battle, triumph, and sweet melancholy. Thank you for listening.
Thank you. Thank you. Tonight, I'm going to play the first movement of Prokofiev's cello concertino in G minor with pianist Minhei Choi. Prokofiev died in 1953 and left this piece unfinished. Then the famous cellist Rostropovich and composer Kabalevsky completed it. When I'm playing this piece, I can feel the mood of Prokofiev. It's hauntingly melancholic. But even then, I really love it, this piece, and I hope you enjoy it. Thank you.
time working on this piece, I still don't quite know what to make of it. Is it a telling of a story, perhaps an individual battling their own internal dialogue, or perhaps maybe a series of landscape paintings where each of the sections is depicting a very specific scenery or atmosphere? Or maybe it's none of those things. I'm not really sure, so instead I would like to leave you with the composer's own words about this piece, which were, "I have let my imagination wander at will." Thank you.
Thank you. Mm-hmm.